Hey everyone, it's Norm from Tested, and I got a really fun show and tell for you guys today. Earlier this week on our podcast, Adam Savage Project, we had guest Mike Birbiglia on the show. And when we started off the show, one of the really fun things that we connected with him about was our use of some similar hardware in when doing live stream production. We geeked out about the Blackmagic ATEM Mini. In fact, we're even using the Blackmagic ATEM Mini Pro ISO model that they sent us to check out for the past couple weeks, and we've been employing it in our live stream. So if you've been watching any of Adam's live stream builds that we've been doing, or the one we did with Jen this week as well, we've been using that device. And in fact, that's what I'm using right now in my home studio to record this video. So I can switch it over, and you can see this is the Blackmagic ATEM Mini Pro ISO. It's been out for a couple months now. It's been very popular among streamers, among video production enthusiasts, and even people who work in the professional video production business who have now had to work from home. So I wanted to go over our experience with it and run down some of its features, some things that we like, some things that we wish they could improve on, in case you're interested in this type of live mix video production. So a device like this, and we've switched back to the actual device, it's really small, really compact. It's basically a hardware switcher with a bunch of extra features. So way back early in the summer, I talked about using software like OBS to capture multiple HDMI inputs and do something like in live mix via just software and capturing HDMI over USB capture sticks. And those have basically become commodity items. You can get something like this for $15, $20, has HDMI in, plugs over USB. They used to be very expensive, but because everyone's working from home now, this has actually become, if you can find them, a pretty easily attainable piece of technology. And if you have USB inputs on your computer or just a USB hub, you can mix those HDMI inputs with OBS software, and it has a lot of powerful functionality that you can do to switch between your inputs and also through games like game capture for Twitch streamers. And I've been really enjoying that, but then that's also a lot of your production banking on the software being reliable and working, and especially if you're using that same computer to do something like play a game for a live streaming, or if you're on a laptop. You know, I've had instances where OBS has crashed or the recording just couldn't keep up. And so we looked into hardware options, something dedicated that can switch between those inputs as well as capture the video, and that's what Blackmagic has put out. So looking at this, last year they put out just the ATEM Mini, which is the same form factor device. It was missing a few of the buttons on the side here and didn't have some important functionality, but what they do share is that basically their input. So if we tilt this up, you got power here, and you have four HDMI inputs that you can switch through. It's actually, I believe, yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, as well as two audio inputs as well. 3.5 millimeter stereo jacks. You can get an XLR converter for that. But basically allows you to press these hardware buttons to switch between them, and built in, super easy to use. You can do cuts, so very easily switch between camera one and camera two, or do something like a dip, so dip to white between camera one and camera two as well. And what I have camera three on is actually a view of the multi-view. Sorry for the infinite picture right here, but this is basically just an HDMI monitor. So there is HDMI output here, and I can see all my different inputs. You can load up via desktop software some media, and you can very easily, like I said, just switch between them. There goes that dip again, or you can use a mix right there and dissolve into your different inputs. It's just right out of the box, works great. And for our purposes, when we want to set up a live stream in the cave for Adam, this is just become a rock solid, reliable piece of hardware. I set up my DSLR right there, have mini HDMI out, plug that into the switcher. Depending on the camera you have, you can get a clean HDMI feed just by tapping on your display settings. So right now, for example, if we look at this is what my Canon camera would have been seeing, would have been projecting. So there goes the autofocus, all these menu options. But if you press that a couple times, then you get a clean HDMI feed. And we've been using that as our A camera. We also have been using an iPhone. So I have right here my iPhone with a dongle, so lightning to HDMI as well as power. And if you use an app like Filmic Pro, you can also turn off all the UI so you're not doing just screen capture. You see the UI on the phone itself, but what the HDMI outputs is a clean signal as well as audio. Filmic Pro is one of our favorite video capture applications. So using that for this kind of B-cam, close-up cam. And then, you know, we have our professional grade cameras as well. So our C cam out there is actually our best camera. This is our Sony FS5, and that's just going over the shoulder right now looking at the monitor. All of these devices have HDMI out, and you know, when they're dedicated cameras, professional grade cameras like DSLRs or video production camera, the HDMI out is not only clean, but also doesn't, you can also record while you have the output as well. So I record locally on my DSLR, record locally on the FS5, and of course we record locally on the iPhone. The iPhone has had issues where if you're recording on a processor intensive application, as well as HDMI out, you could have some drop frames. But all in all, when we've been doing it with the switcher here, it's been pretty clean. And hopefully as you're watching this right now, it's a clean image without latency or drop frames. So for HDMI inputs, and on the side here, you also have HDMI out. That's what you're seeing on the monitor for that multi-view. And then there's also a USB port and Ethernet port. And that's where the extra functionality in the Pro and the ISO models, which came out this year, really come in handy. So there was a Pro model which doubled the price. The ATEM Mini is $300 and the ATEM Mini Pro is $600. And what the Pro allowed you to do was have USB functionality for not only recording, but also for extra camera control and mixing control in via a laptop. So right now you can see I actually have this recording on my Samsung solid state drive. The faster the drive, the better, especially when we get to the ISO features. But this red light here indicates that I'm actually recording everything we're filming off of that USB, and it's being saved here, which is different than when we would do it with a live stream, because what the live stream would actually do is I would plug this USB port into my laptop, and then it treats everything coming out of this device, everything that's mixed, as a webcam, essentially, which is super cool because not only can I have that multi-view monitor for monitoring all the inputs and doing the switching behind the scenes production, the laptop that I'm using as our live stream laptop, the thing that's connected to YouTube, I can do all our configuration settings, that just treats, or a Zoom call can treat anything coming out of the ATEM Mini Pro as a webcam. And that's how we've been doing the live stream. But you also notice that there's only one USB port here. And so one thing I really wish this had was multiple USB ports, because right now, because of the way it encodes video and the way it sends a signal out, you can only do either record to disk or use the device as a webcam. And because we like using this as the webcam functionality for our live streams, we'll monitor that, we're losing the ability, the Pro model ability, the extra $300 we've paid for this to record to disk. But there's also a way to stream it directly from the device via Ethernet as well. So there's that last port right here, Ethernet port, and you plug that in internet and you have the USB plugged into your computer with the ATEM software, and you can then copy your stream key from YouTube, from Twitch, right into the software, and then you have a dedicated button where you can just press on air, and then that will just stream to your service of choice, even without the laptop connected. And there are other nice features, nice to have features. So you got picture in picture, which I can turn on. Although if you don't plug it into a computer and run the software, the default for your picture in picture is gonna be input one. And you can do things like position it in the four corners, but it's much more powerful when you do have it plugged in to the control software, because then you can actually expand the size of the PIP, add things like borders and drop shadows, and do all sorts of things like fancy chroma keying, as well as like load up media images. So there's one still button right here, and I have a random photo loaded up, so you can transition to that. You can go to a black image, or you can go back to your live video. So what I really like about this device is that it works well plugged into a computer and not plugged into a computer. Like if you just want to bring it on location, bring it to a work site, plug in your cameras, you don't need to have the extra software control. Or if you want, you can have that software control even done remotely. There's so many extra features that we haven't even tapped into in terms of remote control over IP of this. I mean, and Blackmagic has done a pretty good job of reading their forms, so updating the firmware and getting the features more rock solid. So, one last thing though is the ISO functionality, and that's the latest model. So the ATEM Mini just does the HDMI switching. The Pro lets you record a mix down of this onto a USB device. And then the ISO allows you not only to get this mix down, this live mix of what I've been doing right here, but also each individual feed gets recorded as a separate video as well as a DaVinci project to allow you to edit that. Now, we edit in Premiere primarily here at Tested, so we just kind of import those MP4s, but they're the same length, of course, as well as the mixdown. And this functionality, I think, it's a really nice to have. It's an extra $300. I don't think it's essential because you can, like I said, record locally on your cameras, but I was really impressed by the image quality of these ISO images and videos, what I mean. So one of my fears is that because this is all H.264 compression and it maxes out at 1080p60, you know, if you have a 4K camera, you're gonna get better image quality out of your 4K camera than what the Blackmagic is gonna be able to record locally here. And the mixdown, if you look at the bit rate, it's relatively low, it's under 10 megabits. But the individual ISO videos are actually at variable bitrate really high. Like what's coming out of my camera right here is 35 megabits. What's coming out of that Sony camera is a 45 megabit file, really large files, but it's retaining all of the image quality. No compression that I can see, at least, that you not notice because you're going to go through what, a YouTube or Vimeo compression anyway. And the only thing you have to deal with is potentially any kind of drop frames you're getting from those HDMI signals. So we've been really enjoying this. I think that the sweet spot is probably the Blackmagic ATEM Mini Pro, not necessarily the ISO. And I think this is a fantastic, you know, for this price point, fantastic product for people, small production teams, even big production teams who want to expand their live mixing capabilities. We've tried this not only with, you know, this nest of cables plugged into here, but also with wireless HDMI, and works great with the wireless HDMI system that Joey tested a few weeks back. And this is something we definitely want to integrate fully into our production suite as we work back in to the office and do more of this in the coming year. So wanted to share this with you guys. I know a lot of you folks out there have been using this already, but if you haven't heard about it, definitely worth checking out. And thanks to Blackmagic for sending this unit to us to check out as well. This has really changed the look of our live streams and, you know, our other standard videos as well. So thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.